A strong earthquake jolts the southern Philippines nearly 2 weeks after a similar quake left several dead in the region. A Philippine court dismisses the bid of Datu Andalam Patuan Jr. to reopen the trial into the Maguindanao massacre. A decision on the case could be handed down next month. Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte admits the search for the next national police chief is proving to be difficult. And overseas, British lawmakers reject Prime Minister Boris Johnson's call for an election in December. Good afternoon. I'm Carmina Constantino. Dateline Philippines begins right now. Welcome to the program. We begin in the southern Philippines, where a magnitude 6.6 earthquake struck nearly 2 weeks after a similar quake rocked the region. The epicenter of Tuesday's tremor was located off Cotabato, according to the Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology. Intensity 7 was felt in parts of Cotabato and Kidapawan City, intensity 6 in Davao City and Coronadal City. FIVOC says it expects damages and aftershocks.
Tectonic po ito and almost same dun po sa nangyari no October 16 yung location. May existing fault na po yan. Ongoing pa yung kanyang paggalaw. So yun nga po yung kaya nga po minomonitor ng people. Yung mga nagkaroon po ng damage before, kailangan another round ng inspection dun sa mga gusali sa area.
Inspections are underway at school buildings in general at Santo City, where classes have been suspended in all levels after the quake triggered evacuations in schools and hospitals. Power outages have also been reported. Last October 16, a magnitude 6.3 tremor jolted Mindanao, claiming at least 5 lives. This morning's quake related to the magnitude 6.3 quake that hit Mindanao some 2 weeks ago. That's according to Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology Officer in Charge Renato Solidum. Solidum explains the area is a seismic zone and underground movement is still ongoing. But FIVOC quashed fears of a possible tsunami.
Kadalasan po sa isang lugar na merong malakas na paglindol, nagkakaroon po ng mga aftershocks. Literally, by definition, mas maliit sila, pero hindi po natin kasi dinidiscount o inaalis yung posibilidad na magkaroon ng mas malakas pang paglindol doon sa lugar ng Tulunan, kasi nung 6.3 na lindol ang pinakita noong October 16, ito ay hindi pa fully kasing lakas na pwede niyang maibigay base sa haba ng mga faults na namapa. So hindi natin inalis yung posibilidad na may malaki, at yun po yung nangyari nga kanina. Marami pong faults po doon. Ang importante kasi, seismic zone yun. At ang kailangan lang natin maintindihan ay yung lugar na yan ay gumagalaw pa. Wala pong tsunaming mangyayari. Mga kababayan po natin sa Southern Mindanao, sa mga baybayin, coastal areas po, huwag po silang mag-alala. Walang tsunaming mangyayari kasi, well, inland, nasa kalupaan po ang paglindol.
The earthquake that hit this morning is stronger than the one that rocked Cotabato weeks ago. That's according to the province's acting governor, Lala Mendoza. She says infrastructure damage assessment is underway, and among the most damaged structures so far is the provincial capital complex.
I believe this is stronger than the previous one, and unfortunately, we have yet to reconstruct the first damaged buildings, and now we have a new situation. Classes are now suspended. In the provincial capital complex, we have suspended as well the work in the complex because we can see damage from the ceiling to the walls in some of our buildings.
The Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology also warning of more tremors.
We're still studying if this is just it's still part of the series of earthquakes that is happening. We know that this area is a seismically active region. There are sources of earthquakes around this area. So we always expect that there will be some strong earthquakes happening in this area.
Disaster officials in Davao City also inspecting government buildings following Tuesday's strong earthquake. Mayor Sara Duterte says they expect a report from authorities within hours. The city hall has already been given an all clear, but several business establishments have reported sustaining damage. Classes in private and public schools have been canceled.
The City Disaster Risk Reduction Management Office, QRTP, is already out inspecting public infrastructure, roads and bridges. We do not advise evacuation for Davao City residents, but we leave the decision of evacuation of private.
Retail giant SM conducting a thorough inspection of all its facilities in Mindanao. The company says all personnel inside its malls were safely led to designated evacuation areas during the tremor, which happened before mall opening hours. SM assures the public the safety of customers, tenants, and employees is the company's utmost priority. The palace, meanwhile, appeals for Filipinos to remain calm but vigilant following the strong earthquake in Mindanao. It calls on the public to refrain from spreading disinformation that may cause undue alarm. It adds all responsible government agencies and local government units are already assessing the situation and coordinating relief operations. No reported critical incidents in Cagayan de Oro, where intensity 6 was felt this morning, when a magnitude 6.6 earthquake hit the southern Philippines. That's according to Nick Habagat of the Provincial Disaster Office. He said initial assessments reveal no major damage in schools and hospitals. Habagat added shopping malls are closed as well, or are being closed, pending an evaluation amid reports of minor cracks in some facilities. Two teams have been deployed to inspect the integrity of structures across the city.
We will proceed in the evaluation of all the structures, private and government buildings, and all the bridges in the city, and then hopefully we can submit the final report this afternoon.
President Rodrigo Duterte admits the search for a new leader for the Philippine National Police Force is proving to be a difficult task. Duterte says his primary consideration in choosing the next police chief is honesty. The police force is being hounded by a drug recycling scandal involving its former chief, General Oscar Albayalde.
I'm trying to review everybody's record. And I need time. Baski, bobo ka, hindi ka number one sa class mo noon. Whether PNPA or PMA. Even if you are the goat of the class, but if you are the honest guy, I will go for you. There's a dent in your reputation. You're done. Wala ka na. Out.
President Duterte, meanwhile, refused to comment about Albayalde's fate. The chief executive says he's leaving it to the Department of Interior and Local Government, as well as to the ombudsman, to decide on the cases of Albayalde and the rogue police officers who allegedly sold the illegal drugs that they themselves confiscated during anti-narcotic raids.
Kung totoo ito, expect really the maximum that I can impose. And I can assure you that the next PNP chief would lead this organization correctly. At kayong mga nandyan sa droga, as I have said, do not destroy my country. Because I will kill you. This is preserving the Republic of the Philippines. Protecting our children.
Meanwhile, President Duterte bears more details on his motorbike accident that happened 2 weeks ago. In a sit-down interview with ABS-CBN's Ted Filon, the chief executive blamed the wrong fit on the bike frame.
Yung motorcycle mataas.
Mm-hmm.
So, ang dapat ang motorcycle mo is yung dalawang paa mo nakadikit.
Uh-huh.
Grounded
nakalapat talaga. Sa opo.
Ito kasi mataas. Ang umaabot lang sa akin, ang the tip of my ngayon, nung pagparking ko, medyo malakas siguro ang takbo. Pag ganun ko, I was trying to maintain the balance. Bumigay yung sapatos ko. Nung natanggal yung sapatos ko, diretso na. And so, then, bagsak.
The president said the accident has triggered his back pains to return, but he's looking forward to riding again.
May motor ako na bago na medyo pababa. Alam mo naman, you ride the motor.
Oh, yes, sir. Opo.
Alam mo, the rule sa motor is, pag sumimplang ka, kailangan sumakay ka ulit. Kasi pag hindi, abutin ka ng kabag, then you are done. Takot ka na.
A Quezon City court has junked the bid of the prime suspect in the Maguindanao massacre. Dato Andal Unsay Ampatuan Jr. wanted to reopen the trial into the case. The move paves the way for a possible decision on the case in November. Ampatuan filed a motion in October claiming that the prosecution's primary witness, former Vice Mayor Sukarno Badal, had supposedly approached them through a representative to recant his testimony. Badal had earlier claimed Ampatuan himself led the armed group and brought the convoy of 58 people, mostly journalists, to a hilly area where they were shot, killed, and buried 10 years ago. But Badal, in open court on October 17, denied Unsay's claim about recanting his testimony, saying Ampatuan was just trying to delay the case. This led Quezon City Regional Trial Court Branch 221 Judge Jocelyn Solis Reyes to deny the motion for lack of merit. The Maguindanao massacre case has been submitted for decision as of August 22 this year, and the court has 90 days or until November 20 to come out with a verdict, just a few days before the massacre's 10th anniversary on November 23. News overseas, British Prime Minister Boris Johnson suffers another defeat after Parliament rejected his bid for an early election. Meanwhile, the European Union agrees to delay Brexit for another 3 months. This report.
Boris Johnson on Monday lost his latest bid to hold an early general election. But the UK Prime Minister could now attempt another way to send Britons to the polls before Christmas.
We will not allow this paralysis to continue, and one way or another, we must proceed straight to an election.
He says that's what's needed to break the country's Brexit impasse. His Monday evening vote calling for an election was expected to be a challenge.
Because the majority required has not been reached, the Noes have it.
In a House where Johnson lacks a majority, he needed the backing of two-thirds of lawmakers. But the main opposition party, led by Jeremy Corbyn, abstained.
The reason I'm so cautious is, quite simply, I do not trust the Prime Minister.
Order!
It was Johnson's third attempt to call for an early election. Previous attempts were blocked because his opponents wanted to first make sure that Britain would not exit the EU without a deal, something Johnson had threatened. But his do-or-die pledge to leave on October 31st is set to be broken after he was forced by Parliament to ask the EU for a three-month extension. On Monday, 27 members who will remain in the bloc agreed to that delay. But the EU is fatigued by the protracted Brexit crisis, and one diplomat said it was hoped the so-called Brextension would be used wisely. But British politicians are no closer to deciding how, when, or even if the divorce should take place. Johnson says an election is needed.
The government will give notice of presentation for a short bill for an election on the 12th of December.
He could now try and bypass the UK's election rules with a piece of legislation stating that Parliament had decreed an election take place on a certain date. It would only need a simple majority and could get the support of smaller opposition parties who said they would agree to an early election under certain conditions.
On to some sports action now. The Golden State Warriors earned their first win of the new new NBA season, dumping the New Orleans Pelicans 134-123. Two-time MVP Steph Curry had 26 points and 11 assists. Draymond Green added a triple-double for the Dubs, who lost their first two games by 19 points or more. The Warriors lead ballooned to as much as 29 points before the Pelicans made a late rally to make the score more respectable. Brandon Ingram top scored for the Pelicans with 27 points and 10 rebounds. And that's today's online edition of Dateline Philippines. Thanks for joining us. I'm Carmina Constantino. Don't forget to like and share this video and leave your comments below.